Hi friends, welcome to my channel. This video is the second part of the basic tutorials of laptop. In the previous video, we learned about what is computer, who invented the computer, how computer system works, and what are the input devices, and four rules of keyboard. In this video, we learn about mouse, processing unit, and output devices. Let's start continuation for the part 1 video. Mouse is one of the important input device of computer system. Pressing the left button of the mouse will display the menu program indicator. Pressing the right button of the mouse will display the context menu. Main types of mouses are first one mechanical mouse, second one auto mechanical mouse, third one optical mouse. And now processing device, which is the second step of a computer working system. In this unit, all the input data are observed, stored, and processed. The processing device of a computer is known as a central processing unit, which we also known CPU. The CPU consists of three parts. First one is a memory unit, second one is control unit, and third one is arithmetic logical unit. First we learn about memory unit. In this memory unit, the input data stored in the form of binary values. The binary values are 0 and 1. Here one binary value equal to 1 bit, and this binary value units are here. First 8 bits equals to 1 byte. This 1 byte equal to 1 character. And again this 1024 bytes equal to 1 KB, which means kilobyte. And next 1024 kilobyte equals to 1 MB, means megabyte. And next 1024 megabyte is equals to 1 GB, means 1 gigabyte. Next 1024 GB equal to 1 TB, means terabyte. There exist two different type of memory units. First, random access memory, which is also known as RAM. This memory is a temporary memory unit. In this memory, the data can be read and write. And in this memory unit, all data will be erased if we stop power supply. And next, second one, read-only memory, which we known ROM. This is a permanent memory unit. In this memory unit, the data can be read but can't write. And in this memory unit, all data will not be erased if we stop power supply. And now second part of CPU, which is control unit. This unit observes the information or data from input devices and transfer the data to ALU, means arithmetic logical unit, and send the result to the output devices. Next, the last part of CPU, that is arithmetic logical unit. In this unit, the data will be observed, processed, and send the results to the memory unit. This is the CPU of a computer. And now output devices, which is the third step of a computer working system. These are the parts of a computer or a laptop which will help us to show the results of processed data. Now we will learn about some important output devices of a computer. First one is monitor. Monitor is an output device. It looks like a TV screen. The final output of a program can be seen on this monitor only. It shows whatever we type on the keyboard or draw with the mouse. Next, printer. It prints the result of our work from the computer screen on a sheet of paper. This is called a printout. These are the parts of a computer or a laptop that are used for storing data or information. They help us to store data for a long time. First one is hard disk. It is made up of one or more metallic disks. It stores a large amount of information. It contains a storage of minimum 500 GB or 1 TB. Next, floppy disk. It stores small amounts of information or data. It works when it is inserted into the floppy drive. The floppy drive is fixed in the CPU. Next, all we know CD, which is a compact disk. A single CD stores more information than a floppy disk because floppy disk stores a small amount of information. It also works when it is inserted into its separate CD drive. This is also fixed in the CPU. Now we will discuss about some necessarily used input devices of computer. First, headphones, all we know earphones. It is used for listening recorded sound or recorded audios like music albums or film albums, etc. Next, joystick. It is used for playing computer games. Next, microphone. It is used for recording sound. Next, scanner. It copies a picture or images and turns into images that can be saved on a computer in digital formats like JPG, PNG, etc. Next, speakers. These devices are used for listening recorded sounds or audios, etc. Next, web camera. It is used for attending a meeting or talking with video calls, etc. And finally, thank you everyone for your patience. If you like my channel, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends and family members.